I have ethics and I don't take
Yeah, well,
like
it's
that.
All the basic Google bomb, the search engine, that they do all this optimization and stuff. So when you search for anything Windows 7, even you search for Windows 7 failure, there will be some Microsoft booster who's going to use a dramatic headline and then put some promotion of Windows inside. So it's really, really hard to find in search engines specific articles because they try to bury certain things. Okay, so if you know the articles that you wrote about, things you catalog, sometimes you do have to go back to things you wrote. Of things you document, and a lot of what you do in Identica, and I know most of us do, is post links to articles of interest. It's not very easy to know how to find them unless you use keywords, unless you kind of know time. And one of the things about Identica is that it does allow you to look back. I mean, in my case, I also have my dents and my friend's dents going into the IRC channel, so I can even do a search on those using Google. But to actually have the archive, the raw archive, you don't really know what's going to happen in a few years, in 10 years, 20 years, but they do improve the way you work with data. I mean, something like semantic analyzers, we maybe don't see them as very practical now, but in the future, you might be able to have them scan through loads of your personal things and derive conclusions based on these and do a kind of an indexing, a smart indexer of sorts.
Which can be used for good or evil. The other thing, though, is if you have the ability to take it out and convert it to whatever format you want, even if they haven't implemented the ability to take your stream and put it somewhere else, if you are a software developer or you know a software developer, can create something to do that.
So it probably will exist somewhere. Yes,
it makes it fully exportable and reportable.
Yeah, and it probably exists by now. But one of the things that I'll say even more is, I mean, for example, when I wrote all kinds of papers before, is I would do it in LaTeX, and I will make things in a very standard compliant way, so then I'll be able to make web pages out of my papers and put them on a website, and you know, people, you know, search Google and get to the web pages and read my papers. And then I wrote some scripts and with all kinds of pattern scanners and actually to replace and to put all kinds of PDFs inside, so each page contains the link to the PDF and the list of, you know, bib tag and stuff to get some citations for it. And all of these things actually tell you that you need the raw data, you need the actual semantic data, like the structure of the document to produce these things with the section and everything else. And a lot of people don't appreciate the fact that if they only store things in the Word format and if they upload their CV and just like throw it away and keep everything under My Documents and delete things after a year, there is a lot of potential things they could publish or they could make use of and reuse of.
Yeah,
never think about it.
Like I said, it's very different with papers that you've written. And I mean, if I wrote a book and put it online, yes, I'd want a permanent record of that. I wouldn't store it in one place, etc. And I'd want to have ownership of my data. But we're talking, you know, for example, in this case of Identica, we're talking about 140 character messages, which I would regard as a conversation you might have with a friend down the road.
Many of them are pointers.
But again, I mean, you know, if you, for example, I linked about 2 years ago to the alleged threat that Steve Ballmer was to make against Google about him effing killing Google. Now, if you type that into Google search engine, bang, you can find it. So if I really wanted to find the article again, the Google search engine is in such a state now that you can actually just type it in as you say it, and it will find you something related, and you'll find the article, no problem.
I think this kind of leads into the whole question about a Google situation. Yeah.
I'm just going back 6 days now. If I go back 6 days, and I'll just read one of my dents from 6 days ago, and that was this. It's T-Mobile can give me faster connection speed on my tethered HTC than my landline ISP provided by O2, a shocking service, and it's got the hashtag O2 and hash fail. Now, that is no good to me. I'm damn sure it's no good to anybody who reads my dents. And for me, it's what I call throwaway data. I don't mean that as treating any conversation I have with somebody.
That suggests this might be used against you at a later stage, but if you keep the data, it's you who's got the power. There is the question of who owns the data.
And so could anything. I mean, the argument could be that, and I've had this before, I've had this debate with other people, whereby they say, well, if you don't keep it, then somebody could allege 6 years ago use of XYZ. But they could still do that, because they could turn around and say, I deleted the dent. And when we're dealing with data like this, there's no physical way for me
to... There is no way for them to say you should have downloaded a backup of your dent or anything like this a few years later. It only gives you control. It only gives you power.
Until a point, you get the same thing in Google Plus, because unless you turn it off, it CCs you a lot of stuff via email. So you did get a copy of all your Google Plusing.
Well, I mean, there is this shocking revelation that people are that concerned, could do anyway, regardless of the policy that the social networking site, in this case, has on your data. And that's shock of shocks. If you type in a dent and you want to keep it, you just copy and paste it into a text file.
You don't have to do it manually. There is no reason.
There's no reason you should have to do it manual. And a manual copy and paste, if like the reason that keeps coming back up here is the legal liability, manual copy and paste isn't worth the copy and paste it's copy and pasted from.
But we can only talk in our own...
It doesn't have the ID number
We can only talk in our own realm of experience. And like I say, for myself, personally, I think for a lot of identity users, yes, if their account was deleted and they lost all their data, it would be annoying because they've built up communities here, they've got friends, they've got contacts, and they've got followers. But this isn't something that the data itself is not the be-all and end-all. Certainly not in my case. And I'd hazard a guess in many people because we're just putting our thoughts of the day. I've put on my identical, which, funny enough, didn't work in the last hour.
I would agree with you for 9 out of 10 users, like you're saying, it's throwaway data. But because there's that 1 out of 10 users, like Roy here, where it isn't throwaway data...
Do you know the scraper? Does any of you see the... Yeah. Do you know of any other people using the scrapers for things like the Dig and Twitter, actually going page by page by page and downloading these things systematically? That's very expensive for the companies offering the service, because they would rather these people would be able to have a central point to just get the primary keys and all the data that they have. They'd be able to look back at these things in any case. And one of the reasons I'm very sensitive to that is because I used to contribute to a site called Netscape.com. I was actually a paid contributor at the time. And I posted about 22,000, I believe, items there, and the site no longer existed. So basically, at one stage, I just knew it was going to shut down, but what can I do to get my data? Nothing. You know, all my tags.
Things like archive hubs. I mean, what started this obsession with backing up stuff like this was, you know, I don't know if anybody remembers Tech TV, but you remember G4 bought Tech TV, and there were a number of people back when Tech TV was around that would just go, you know what, I didn't bookmark it or anything, but I remember at some point Tech TV talked about this, so they just went to Tech TV to look it up as a reference source or something to find the link to the thing they were looking for, because they could find it there quicker, and they knew it wasn't going to come up in Google because it's like a 5-year-old thing, but as soon as they got bought and merged out, which is what everybody is afraid is going to happen to their reference now, and the reference just went away. It was taken offline. It didn't exist anymore. So there's a certain aspect of the tech community when it comes to anything. They want a copy.
Yeah. Did you ever see all of these sites like Fraser Files, all kinds of copies of transcripts of shows being done manually by people? I don't really know. It's probably copyright. They could actually take these things down. And some people, even sometimes reading the transcripts, they used to do it work, even for some of these shows that I liked. It's quite interesting. And I tended to keep quite a few things. And I think these days, we assume it's on the web, so it will be accessible somewhere. But, you know, a few years down the line, even the web archive is not of much use. And you might not have the URL to search on. So, and those, the link shorteners are horrible. I mean, the founder of the web was complaining about them because they destroy the preservation of things. I don't really think many of those sites have already a business reason to exist in 10 years and to translate these URLs to expand.
Dead end.
Yes. Well, if you can make sense of the code and you can just do guesswork as much as your doc can, well, you maybe you'll be able to make sense of that. Otherwise, it's maybe the headlines. Maybe you'll be able to search by headlines, but then you depend on what's online, because search engines like Google only index things that are actually still in existence. They're not going to...
Yeah, as soon as they realize the page no longer exists, the cache copy is deleted.
Yes, and the web archive doesn't let you search the content just by sites and URLs. So then you...
They're trying to change that with things like the article tag. So.
All right, yeah, hopefully. I know they had some financial difficulties a while ago, but...
Well, next show, we can maybe delve a little bit deeper into this. It's now 11:05 in the UK, and I'll be very shortly getting the look from the wife that it's time to shut things off. So
we were supposed to be short. Yes.
We said before the show we'll make it about an hour, and it's gone considerably over that now. So if I'm in agreement with both of you two, we'll sort of end the show round about now. Just before I go, a couple of things. if you would like to come on the show, please send us a line and tell us what you'd like to talk about. You'd be more than welcome to come on. And you can contact us at mine, Roy's, or Rusty's email address. There'll be links on the show notes for that. Thank you very much for listening yet again to another show. And it's quite nice because on Diaspora and Google Plus, actually, I've been